about this one. Lord Jesus. So I'm in pretty good. I'm stronger than I've been in a long time, I tell you. All right, y'all love me?
Yeah.
Amen. Praise God. I wish, amen, praise God, we could see the vision and the importance of really cultivating a rich sense of rejoicing. God will do great things. Amen. When you feel poor, when you feel, amen, that you don't have what it takes, when you're contrite, when you really begin to look to the Lord and tremble at His word, then God will begin to release His grace upon your life. Amen. Now, here is what I said last week in so many words. God's favor, God's grace, is God's strong inclination to show favor and kindness. Amen. To show, that means to show preferential treatment as to a favorite daughter or son. God will show you preferential treatment if you really begin to, amen, operate in His grace. How many know that some kids get treated better than the others? In so many ways. Now the kid that's obedient, that's, you know, that will carry out, you know, the will of the father, the mothers, most times they are dealt with different. But those that are always rebelling, always out of line, always pulling tricks and lying, and trying to what, scheme and plot and all that. Amen. You have to what? You have to rule them with an iron hand. Amen. You, I mean, you treat them different. Amen. Although you show them all love. That right?
That's right.
Amen. So that's the way it is when it comes to God's favor. People that God said, if you delight in me, I'll give you what? The desires of your heart. How many believe that God will show a difference between a person that delight and the person that don't delight? See, God is not a respecter of person, but He is a respecter of faith. See, when you don't rejoice, amen, amen, we're going to get some of this stiffness out of our bones, our arthritis, whatever it is. Amen. Amen. The water will get it all, y'all. It's going to take some anointing. Somebody said the anointing is the thing that what? Breaks the yoke. And here's the thing, that when you begin to rejoice, that shows your faith.
Yes.
So Lord, amen, I am thanking you for the thing that I see you already have done. You're looking beyond the condition of a state that exists. And you're seeing the what? Completed of the finished work. How many can say amen? And say, Lord, I thank you for making it. Hallelujah. Making it so. You know, God rejoices. He, amen. When He gets to see people that can, will praise Him beforehand for the thing that they are absolutely sure that He's going to do for them or He's going to manifest for them, you know, that honors Him. That honors Him. Everybody said that honors God. And then God looks up on those kind of acts as what? Amen. With what? Favor. Amen. Praise God. So that's the reason why you want to rejoice and stay extremely glad. You don't care what the things are going good or going bad. Amen. In everything, give thanks, rejoice evermore. Is that right? And the Bible says that the Lord will do great things. He says, fear not, all ye lands, rejoice and be glad, for the Lord will do great things.
Yes, amen.
Amen. So, how many want preferential treatment?
Amen.
How many can say amen? Preferential, preferential.
Amen.
All right, now, favor is a working of God that brings you to a place where people are supernaturally inclined to respond favorably toward you without any outward reason for doing so. Amen. That's what favor is a working of God that brings you to a place where people are supernaturally attracted to you or inclined to respond to you favorably, amen, without any outward reason for doing so. Amen. Praise God. So that is the reason why we want to actually stay humble, or stay humble or dependent upon God. Because God gives what? Grace to the what? To the humble. How many say grace?
Grace.
He resists the proud, but he what? Gives grace. Yeah, man's pride will bring him low, but honor shall uphold the humble in spirit. I like that. A man's pride. This is Proverbs 29:23. A man's pride shall bring him low. That's the reason why God wants us to rely on him rather than trusting in ourselves. A man's pride will bring him what? Low. Amen. But honor shall uphold the humble in spirit. So God is going to what? He's going to exalt those that are what? Humble, or those that choose to rely on him. How many can say amen?
Amen.
Now I'm going to give you in a few minutes three things that humility will definitely release into your life. Three things that humility, okay, but it's contingent upon, amen, praise God, humbling yourself. You humble yourself. Now, we say humbling, humility is relying on God rather than trusting in yourselves. We gave the example of the Pharisee and the publican that trusted in himself. Amen. That the Pharisee trusted in himself. He went up to pray, and he prayed this prideful prayer. Lord, I'm glad I ain't like this old publican, extortioners and adulterer. If he was looking down, pointing fingers at the publican, the sinner, amen, but he was trying to magnify himself by expressing all of these prideful things, amen, about himself. I give tithe, I do this, I do that. But the Bible says God resisted him. God didn't even look at him. But the poor publican that humbled him says, Lord, I don't pay tithe, you know, I don't keep the law, I ain't a righteous man, amen, but Lord, I just want you to have mercy on me.
Amen.
I'm a sinner.
Amen.
Amen. He humbled himself, amen. And the scripture says he went away justified. How many can say amen?
Amen.
Now, how many know that Joseph, as we said last week, that Joseph was a great example of one that did not take the credit for the things that God revealed to him? Amen. This is what he said. Do not interpretation belong to God? Amen. What was the, amen, the answer that he gave Pharaoh when, it was Pharaoh, I believe, when he was called upon to interpret the dream. This is what he said. Amen. This is exactly what he said. He didn't take the credit. He says that it is not me in me, amen, to interpret this. I don't have the interpretation. It's not in me. Amen. He was totally dependent upon God. When he was called upon to interpret the dreams of those two men. One was a butler and one was a baker. And when he came before Pharaoh, this is what he said. He said, God shall give Pharaoh an answer of peace. Amen. Amen. So you can see the reason why God delivered turn to Psalms 105. The reason why God delivered Joseph. See, God works. He favors those that really trust him and give him the credit. Amen. Praise God. This is Psalms 105. I just want you to turn. This is really amazing. Very powerful passage. It says this. He sent a man, 105:17. Say I'm there, Psalms 105:17. He sent a man before them, even Joseph, who was sold for a servant, whose feet they hurt with fetters. He was laid in iron until the time that his word came. The word of the Lord tried him. The king sent and loosed him, even the ruler of the people, and let him go free. He made him lord of his house and ruler of all his substance, to bind his princes at his pleasure and to teach his senators wisdom. So he was released from prison. You know, initially he was in iron. But as time progressed, he got more and more favor. So he became a supervisor of everybody in prison. Everything in prison came under his authority. Amen. Amen. He always attracted the favor of God. After being sold in Egypt, amen, he ended up in Potiphar's house, but he was exalted there, right? He was placed over everything that pertained to Potiphar. Amen. How many know that's favor? The Bible said everything that he touched, God caused it to what? Prosper. Amen. Praise God. Joseph was a... I mean, if you haven't read that lately, you need to read that again. Amen. Also the book of Daniel. These are two men that definitely operated in God's favor. God favored them. God gave them grace. Amen. It was because of their disposition and their humility, amen, that God was able to do these things. Now, when it comes to Daniel, we know that Paul and Jesus, the scripture says, let's look at Philippians 2. Amen. See, Jesus didn't do anything in his own strength either. Amen. He did not do anything in the strength of his ability. He always trusted God. Amen. He said, my doctrine, my teaching ain't mine, my works ain't mine. Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Okay, Philippians 2, I want you to look at that. It says, verse 5, everybody help me to read this. Let this what? Mind be in you, which was also in what? Who being in the form of God, thought it not what? Robbery to be equal with God, but made of himself no reputation, and took upon him the form of a servant, and was made in the likeness of men. Alright, and being found in fashion as a man, he humbled himself. I want you to just underline, he humbled himself. See, that's the reason why, amen, Jesus has a name now that's above whatever name. We're going to see that in a minute. And became obedient unto what? Death, even the death of the cross. Now look at verse 9. Wherefore, let's read that. God had also hath what? Highly what? Exalted him and given him a name which is above what? Every name. That at the name of Jesus, every knee should what? Bow of things in heaven and things in earth and things under the earth. And that every tongue should confess that Jesus Christ is Lord to the glory of God the Father. Now, why is Jesus' name a name that's above every name? Now, this is 2011, what we call this, A.D.? Is that right? A.D. means what? In the year of our what? Lord Jesus Christ. See, everything hinges and focuses and revolves around the name of Jesus. How did he get the name? Amen. He was willing to what? Relinquish all that he was in heaven. In other words, his equality with God, right? Amen. All of the outward powers that made him God, he relinquished those and laid them aside, came down in the form of a what? Servant. Everything he accomplished, he had to do it, amen, praise God, with what? Amen, through the Spirit. The Bible says, how God, I like that. This is Acts 10, 38. Is that right, Brother Dean? Acts 10, how God anointed Jesus with what? Power. So he had to, amen, praise God, he had to humble himself and what? Depend on God anointing him. Amen. In heaven, he was already anointed, but he laid that prerogative aside. Amen. Came down in the likeness of what? Sinful flesh. Amen. He had the advantage in heaven being equal with God. But when he came down on the earth, he laid aside his equality. And he became a man just like us, dependent on what? The Holy Ghost to do whatever God wanted to do through him. He said, me, of my flesh, I can't do nothing of myself. But when he was God, amen, he was equal with God. But he laid it aside. Took somebody and said, it means something to, amen, to let go and let God have his way. It means something. Mm-hmm. Hey, hallelujah. All right, payday will come when you what? Let go and let God. How many can say amen? The Bible says, now God has what? Highly exalted him. Jesus became obedient even to the what? After he paid the utmost price. Christ for our redemption. The Bible says what? God, hallelujah, God what? Raised him back. He quickened him who was dead. Hallelujah. Amen. And he became what? Alive in his spirit again. Hallelujah. And God what? Exalted him. Oh, and given him a name. Boy, you say in the name of Jesus, the devils have to what? Back off. Somebody say amen. If you submit yourself to God, you can what? Resist the devil, and the what? Devil will what? Flee from you. I don't know anybody else have the ability, amen, praise God, to cause the devil to run devils out, to drive devils away. In the name of Brother Travis, believe this ain't happen. Maybe it won't happen for me and Sister Shirley. In the, amen. In the name of Sister Shirley. Will the devils go? Hey, God has given what? Him a name. It was because of the price he paid. It was because he stripped himself of all that pertained to what? Himself. And he wanted what? To be totally committed to carrying out God's will. He laid himself, amen, down. Hey, hallelujah. Amen. When you're willing to get rid of your flesh and yourself, you're thinking, oh, I believe I do it this way. Praise and worship comes, we say, well, I don't see how I have to do it. Amen. I don't see how I have to keep up all that racket. And I worked hard all week. I don't feel like doing all of that. See, you're not willing to relinquish your what? Your ways. Amen. But I'm going to try it every time to relinquish mine. Amen. If he's running up and down these aisles. I'm looking a little stiff, but I ain't that stiff now. Amen. Praise God. The scripture says, well, whosoever, whatever you ask the Father in my name. This is what Jesus said. He's going to do it every time, every time, every time. The confidence that we have in him. When he asks anything according to his will, he what? Hears us. If we know he hears us, then we know that we have the petitions of those things that we are asking of him. Lord God honors that name. When God say, amen, see the name of Jesus behind that prayer. Hey, Father, I'm asking this not for my own glory, but I'm asking it what, for your glory in Jesus' name. That clinches the deal in Jesus' name. God honors that name. And that name has become what? So highly exalted. Amen. Stay humble. Amen. Brother Mariko, I think Sister Jessica will also help you to stay humble. But hey! We know it's a work of the heart, but it's a natural thing that sometimes you have to have what, certain restraints, and sometimes people have to call your hand. Sister Hill keeps me in line. Amen. In a few minutes, y'all know what I'm talking about. I have to stay humble. I have to submit. Submit yourself to the Lord. Amen. See, submit means you submit to the Word, you submit to Jesus, you submit to God, you submit to those in authority. Is that right? Is that right? You submit to those that you are in a partnership with, in a love relationship, in a marriage. You have to submit. She submits to me, and I submit to her. Is that right? And that's what we mean when we say, sometimes people say, I ain't gonna do what no man tell me to do. I don't do what men say. All I do is what Jesus said. The Spirit, Jesus of God, got to tell me. I ain't gonna do nothing, amen, that no man say. You know they're way off. Amen. How can you love God whom you've never seen and not love and respect people that you see every day? Hallelujah. So you got to be willing to submit. If you want power to resist the devil, you got to submit to God. How many understand what I'm saying? When we say submit to God, then you can resist the devil. See, I don't care how much you say, devil, get out of this house. Sometimes we go through all these emotions. Kick the devil out. And kick him in the butt. Boom. You know, about 80%, probably 90% of the ability to resist the devil is obedience. Submit. Say, right, if you don't submit, the devil ain't gonna respect you. He don't have to. You can say in Jesus' name all day. If you ain't living, I'm gonna come up to dog me. If you ain't living nothing, if you ain't submitting to God. And I don't mean that. Well, the word didn't say I have to do this, but sometimes, amen, praise God, you gotta go beyond the word, go beyond what? Amen, praise God, go beyond the pastor sometimes. Amen. And you gotta what? Whoever got authority over you, God wants you to what? Submit to them.
That's right.
You can't be out of submission with people that's on a lower level and still call yourself submitting to somebody. Amen. The Word or Jesus or Holy Ghost or whoever you call these, that you vow to what? To submit to. Amen. But you gotta resist the devil. If you submit to God, He gives you power to what? Resist the devil. And the devil will what? Flee. Everybody said the devil will flee.
The devil will flee.
He'll run away in what? Panic. He'll run away. Y'all want to see me run a little bit? Well, it just gets my joy bells ringing and it just turns me on. Hallelujah. The devil will flee.
Yeah.
get away real fast. That means that name got some power in it, right?
Amen.
In the name of what?
Jesus.
Everybody just say, in the name of what?
Jesus.
Say it again, in the name.
Jesus.
Hallelujah. Yes. God has given him a name.
Yes.
Every knee bows and every what?
Yes.
Tongue has to what? Confess. Jesus is what? Lord, I'm not about nothing, but the God in me.
Yes.
I can do all things through who? That's the idea. I can do all things through who?
Christ.
Greater is he that is what?
In
me than he that is in the world.
Amen.
See, Paul's attitude, the reason why Paul was such a great man, about half of all of the letters and the writings in the New Testament reflects around Paul. He's the person that's responsible for establishing Christianity, the word and the standards for living and all of the different revelations that we have in the Bible. He's the one that's responsible for all of that. But Paul said, I'm crucified with Christ. Nevertheless, I live, but it's not me. He didn't give himself no credit, although he was a man of great revelation. He said, I'm less than the least of all my brethren. He said, I am what I am because of the what? Grace of God. But he was totally, completely dependent on what? Jesus. He said, it's the Christ in me. It's Jesus in me. Doubtless I count all things but loss for the excellency of the knowledge of Christ Jesus my Lord. For him I count all things but dung that I might what? Win him and be found in him. Not having my own righteousness, which is hallelujah, is not for law, but the righteousness is by faith just in Christ. That's the righteousness I want. Amen. Praise God. And I want you to turn to Philippians 3:3. I'm going to shut down. But this was Paul's key. See, three things that God said, if you humble yourself, he'll give you grace. He'll give you grace. In other words, grace is God doing for you what you don't have the ability to do for yourself. He will give you favor. He'll cause people to respond favorably.
Yeah.
He'll give you favor toward God and man. Amen. Someone said that grace is all of God's mercy, all of God's kindness, all of his ability, all of his love, all of his wisdom, and all of the things that God is all about. released into your life. It's the sum total of all that God has done for us through Christ. That's what grace is all about. And all that God is doing for us right now through the power of the Holy Spirit. All that will give you some idea as to the extent of God's grace. Philippians 3:3. To sum it up, see, God gives grace to the humble. God also said that he will exalt them in due time. Amen. God resists the proud, but he gives what? Grace to the humble. He will exalt them in due time. That's, amen, also found in that passage in James 4, verse 6, I think, 7, 8, or 9, or 10, somewhere in there. God said he will exalt. How many want to be exalted? How many want to make more than $25,000 a year?
Yeah.
So I said, well, Pastor, I ain't even there yet. Well, God can make it $125,000. Is that all right?
Yes.
That'll work. Amen. How many believe that God can give you favor?
Yes.
God can give you wisdom.
Yes.
Hallelujah. 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 He's going to exalt you. Baby, turn to somebody and say, God is going to exalt you if you humble yourself. He's going to exalt you. He's going to exalt you. Amen. I'm praying that everybody here, will, your income will double. Amen. Before you die. Some of y'all are going to double probably within another year or so. Some of y'all might double within the next few months. Amen. Is that a big thing for God to do? Mm-hmm. He's able to do what? Exceeding anything you can what? Think or ask. Amen. It's the degree that you're willing to what? Trust Him. Let go. Amen. Magnify Him real big. Show out in church. Amen. Show out in church. Amen. When the praise and worship team get up, amen, just get up and just like. Amen. Praise God. Amen. I'm gonna see if I can, amen, can help y'all. Amen. Sometimes maybe just do something like this, you know. Yeah. Anybody can do something like that? Is that too tough? Y'all don't believe it's something in leaping?
Amen.
Y'all believe it's something in running? And dancing before the Lord? All of that helps to what? Release God's what? Favor. God's grace. He gives grace to them that will what? Amen. Humble themselves. Say, Lord, I need you. I'm going to dance before you. Hey! Okay. Close this out. He will exalt you in due time. He'll give grace to the humble. He'll exalt you. And the third thing I've already mentioned, if you submit to God, you can resist the devil, and the devil will what? Flee. Power to resist the devil. Those are three things that God promises he would do if you what? Humble yourself. Alright. Close it out. Paul sums it up this way. I like this. Read that for Mr. Steele. Philippians 3:3. It sums it up. Okay, everybody.
Which worship God in the Spirit.
All right, okay, let's end on that.
And trust in Christ Jesus and have no confidence in the flesh.
Okay, now that sums it up. We offer circumcision. We what? Worship God in Spirit. See, that's humility. Y'all have to understand that. That's humility. Not worship Him your way, in a way that's acceptable to Him. How many believe that you have to get out of your flesh, get out of yourself? How many know that when we come and act the same way, do the same thing, there's a chance that we might be in our flesh. We might be worshiping the Lord in our flesh. Ask somebody next to you, are you worshiping the Lord in your flesh, or are you worshiping Him in your spirit? Some say, Pastor, I don't know the difference. Some say, I don't know the difference, Pastor. Help me. Amen. All right, Sister Black, you said you know the difference? How many 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 know? How many know that when you walk out of flesh?
Amen.
in the Holy Spirit.
Yes.
Hey, you know that you know, right?
Yeah.
Amen. It's out. It gets finger licking what? Good.
Yes.
You don't care who's looking. You don't care how ugly you are looking, right? You don't care how loud you are what?
Hallelujah.
Shouting.
Yeah.
It feels good.
Yeah. Hallelujah.
The joy of the Lord is my what?
Strength.
Yeah. Amen. We in the circumcision, we worship Him in the Spirit. The second thing, what else we do? We rejoice. See, I said, I'm telling y'all, y'all don't believe that. You rejoice. Everybody just get up and see if you can rejoice any kind of way. We